From opposite sides of the globe, they have come together under one sky. Today, Russia and the USA's brightest stars have descended onto the Orlando ice. Last year, Russia swept through the World Championships. Four disciplines, four gold medals. Claiming the throne as the world's most powerful skating team.
Alexei Yagudin just drew a line in the ice.
Maria Butyrskaya, she was able to give one of the best performances of her life. The USA counters with its own cast of world champions and rising stars. Michael Weiss, the new American champion.
Sarah Hugh, a terrific effort here.
Michelle Kwan.
Michelle Kwan in a class by herself.
She is so special.
Some of skating's most celebrated champions clash today in a matchup of skating superpowers. Which flag of red, white, and blue will fly highest? Russia takes on the USA next. Welcome, everyone, to the Kerry Loschen Figure Skating Classic as we get our season of figure skating underway here on ABC Sports. Along with Peggy Fleming, Dick Button, and Susie Wynn, I'm Terry Gannon. Inside Orlando Arena here in Central Florida, they are not here for individual honors, but for team glory and to represent their country. And here is a look at the Russian team, extremely powerful. All four of the world champions are here, including Maria Butyrskaya, Krylova and Ovsyannikov in dance, Yagudin for the men, Bereznaya Sigrid Lidze in pairs. So a huge task ahead for the Americans. Experienced and inexperienced, the rising stars of the future here as well. Michelle Kwan, of course, heads the list, the former world champion. On the men's side, Michael Weiss, the U.S. champ, Todd Eldridge, a former world champion as well. Now, in each of the four disciplines, the individuals are awarded 6 points for first, 5 for second, on down the list, but they go towards the team score. It's a cumulative team effort in Orlando.
They are the reigning United States silver medalist in pairs. Please welcome Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman.
And on the ice first here in the pairs competition in their second season together, 26-year-old Kyoko Ina and 25-year-old John Zimmerman. They came in second at the U.S. Nationals last season, ninth at the World Championships.
Opening with a split triple twist. Nice, a little shaky on the landing. They're side by side, double axles. Nicely done.
This is where this couple has had trouble meshing their two different styles. She is a supremely athletic and superb technician, and he has had a great amount of flair, and pulling them together is what their goal has been.
Salchow.
You notice this is skated very conservatively. They're still getting used to each other.
All these transitions of coming in and out of moves are still a little bit rough, but that takes time.
This music entitled At the Beginning, and Kyoko says the lyrics certainly reflect their lives, beginning anew after careers with other partners.
Now I know nice inventive exit to that pair spin.
Program is that it all seems to be on one level. Both the music and the choreography seems to be without highs and lows and dramatic moments, although this is a very effective lift.
Nicely done.
A very nice ending to the whole program.
Well, you wonder who their coach will be cheering for. Tamara Moskovina of Russia, of course, also the coach of Bereznaya and Sikhorodlidze, their competitor. And this is, of course, the USA versus Russia here in Orlando. Yoko Ina and John Zimmerman get us underway. Back inside Orlando Arena for the Kerry Lotion Figure Skating Classic and the skating techniques marks for Ina and Zimmerman, 5.4 up to 5.6.
And those are very credible marks. These marks, on the other hand, are quite a bit lower, and I think that's because the judges probably feel that this couple has not yet gelled as two skaters performing as one.
Warm welcome, please, for Elena Bereznaya and Anton Sikhorodlidze.
So here are their competitors here in Orlando, Elena Bereznaya and Anton Sikhorodlidze, the two-time and reigning world champions.
And their music, Tchaikovsky's Sentimental Waltz, and it fits them beautifully.
And the composers, Tchaikovsky, and they consider Tchaikovsky their signature composer.
Performed those first double axels with really good finesse or position, slight hesitations on them. But the rest of their skating is stylish and elegant and ever so beautiful.
And this coming up is a throw triple salchow. Very nice. And in practice, she's been working on a quad, which is spectacular to watch.
This is one of my favorite moves in their repertory of pair skating elements.
And watch these positions in this death spiral. Now he gets up and does a spiral, still holding her in that position. Very inventive, very difficult.
I think they need still work on it, though, so that he can have position and speed and movement that fits that better.
They have such a beautiful line flow over the ice.
The drop out of this, very nice. Very controlled program.
beautiful angles of their body.
These programs are a bit different than the usual competitive programs we see. These are interpretive free skates. There are restrictions on the overhead lifts. And no side-by-side triples are permitted.
Now watch this lift. The very pull up into the air. Now watch her drop down and out and down to a parallel position to the ice. They usually skate with enormous speed. This seems much slower, this program, as they're skating conservatively and holding back in a sense. Good unison. An interesting move, an unusual move, and I don't think particularly successful.
No. But still very elegant.
I think this whole program was a very sort of a tentative one. It wasn't skated with great speed or confidence or security or all-out energy. I think maybe that's because it's the first competition for them of the season.
So the reigning world champions starting a season in which they'd love to capture their third straight world title. Yelena Bereznaya and Anton Sikhiridze.
And this move, I think, is one of their most effective moves and certainly one of the most difficult from a balance point of view and a stretch point of view. And if you notice the split jump, the split move that she's doing, it's a true split and a very difficult position to obtain. And in this lift, great athleticism right here. And watch her turn her now and then drop her down into a low parallel to the ice position right here. She slips down but goes all the way down into that back position.
So tomorrow, Moskvina alongside Yelena and Anton. The first set of marks for skating techniques, 5.4 to 5.8. And now for presentation, 5.6 up to 5.9. So Bereznaya and Sikhiridze edge out Ina and Zimmerman, the two pairs in this competition. So 6 points to the Russian side, 5 to the U.S. So the Kerry Loschen Figure Skating Classic is underway here in Orlando. Terry Gannon, along with Peggy Fleming and Dick Button, we have only just begun what will be the most extensive season of figure skating coverage ever here on ABC Sports. Before we wrap things up in mid-April of next year, we will bring you 14 events and some 41 hours of skating coverage. And Peggy, it all begins right here, right now in Orlando. And the ladies will take the ice a little bit later on. We've got the USA versus Russia. That's a theme we've watched the past two seasons with the ladies. Again, Maria Butyrskaya against Michelle Kwan to start a new season.
Well, Terry, the pressure in this event is really on these two women. Michelle Kwan and Maria Butyrskaya are both world champions, one former and one current. And they are the very best these powerful nations have to offer. And in practice yesterday, Michelle looked comfortable and in shape, and in spite of just starting her freshman year at UCLA. But Maria Butyrskaya looked hungry. She looked confident, inspired, and ready to take on this season.
So that's the marquee matchup. But all three of the ladies who stood on the podium in Helsinki at the World Championships last season are here. And, Dick, the same can be said for the men. But this is a much different format than you see at a World Championship.
Well, do you ever remember going into an old-fashioned store when the proprietor would measure the goods on one side of the scale by placing weights on the other side to keep it in balance? Well, the United States Figure Skating Association may have struck gold with this competition, where the two major themes of skating have finally been balanced equally: athleticism and artistry. They are truly equal in importance here, and what has resulted is some of the best skated programs I've seen in a practice session in a long time. Alexei Yagudin is in the finest condition I've seen him in since he got bounced from the Tom Collins tour for behaving badly. And Michael Weiss is hungry for his first world title to feed his ever-expanding family. And all of this just at the start of a new competitive season.
Great things ahead, but a great way to start here in Orlando, Dick. The men take the ice next in this team competition. The reigning U.S. champion, Michael Weiss. Five-time U.S. champ, Todd Eldridge on the American side. Their competitors, Yevgeny Plyshenko, the young teenager from Russia, and the two-time and reigning world champion, Alexei Yagudin. Russia versus the U.S. continues when we come back to the Kerry Loschen Figure Skating Classic.
From Russia, Yevgeny Plyshenko.
Well, the depth of that Russian team illustrated now with the first man in the senior ranks taking the ice. 16-year-old Yevgeny Plyshenko, a bronze medal at his first World Championships in 98, a silver last year. And he begins to compete here with the Russians leading 12-10 after Klimkin's win over Matt Savoy of the U.S.
Generally, he has extraordinary athletic ability, a lot of flair in his skating, good excitement, great energy. He's really a phenomenal skater. Triple axel. Sparkle to his personality, too. Circular step.
St. Petersburg with his winnings over the past few years. He has bought an apartment there. His father was still living in Volgograd, Russia, where he is originally from. So now they all live and he trains in St. Petersburg.
Mm-hmm.
sit spin position. And notice that he's holding the spin. You don't see that very often. That you can see with the who is limber enough to do that Veelman spin. You know, this was a very interesting program. I thought it was, you know, it shows the flair he has. He's only 16, he has wonderful theatrical sense, and he's a magnificent jumper. But all of the jumps in this program just didn't soar. They didn't quite sing the way he can do it. Maybe that was nerves from the first competition of the year. I don't know.
And we've seen him on those nights when he is in his zone and everything is working right for him. 16-year-old Yevgeny Plushenko, the reigning Russian national champion, by the way, beat out Yagudin last year for that title.
Now on this triple Lutz, watch the toe pick right there and see how turned over it is. The jump is still good, but it's not so fine in this triple toe loop, and you see him struggling at the end. Wonderful first jump, but not quite perfect technique. And here on this layback, you can see the enormous flexibility that he has. He's worked on that since he was a very young man. I mean, there's very few people, either male or female, that can equal this stretch in this Veelman spin.
And a 16-year-old aware of his face up on the Jumbotron, making faces that the crowd has reacted to the last moment or so.
He's got a little bit of ham in him, doesn't he?
Knows how to play to the crowd. Now the first set of marks for skating techniques. 5 sixes and 1 5.7.
And I think those would have been higher had he not struggled on that one jump combination.
Alexei Mishin on his left, his coach.
And his choreographer on the right.
5 sevens and 5 eights for presentation. So higher marks for presentation for Yevgeny Plushenko, the world silver medalist from a year ago.
He's a 5-time U.S. national champion, 1996 world champion, Todd Eldridge.
So Yagudin trying to get his act back together. He looks in great shape here in Orlando. So does Todd Eldridge, although he is battling a foot injury, a reoccurrence of a nagging injury from a year ago. He's spent a lot of time off the ice, and it's one that Todd will have to deal with throughout the season and perhaps get surgery right after the season.
He's skating to the music. The Glory from the Broadway musical The Civil War. It's the third time he has used Civil War themes. The movie Gettysburg was his last two programs.
Timothy Gabel, the 19-year-old American, has already skated, and he received marks ranging from 5.1 to 5.5, and he was not, by the way, able to complete his quadruple jump.
See how the battle sabers shine, and the shadows the flags all throw.
Jump slightly off angle, but he does that quite frequently in jumps, and then like a cat he lands on a good back outside edge.
Let us give the last full measure, gather for the glory.
An excellent spinner, probably the best male spinner in the world. Certainly close to it, if not.
For the glory.
Palazzo. Falling out on the landing. Let's watch him go from back outside edge. Again, he seems to always be slightly off in the air, yet the jumps are usually very secure, very complete.
And Dick, it's on the landing of those jumps that Todd really worries about his foot.
But you can see the back inside edge mm-hmm. as he landed. The edge switched. It should have been an outside edge. It ended up being an inside edge. Again, his backspin, just brilliant. Double axle there, elected to do a single one. I wonder if it's a problem at his ankle. But look here at this spin. The security of this, the speed of it. The position, the pancake position, and now this back scratch spin and the overhead arms. He's just a wonderful spinner and usually such an extraordinary and steady skater. I hope he's not going to have problems with that ankle over the course of this winter.
Keeping his fingers crossed. He said he can land the wrong way, he can swell up, and he can't skate at that point. He's hoping to get through the entire season.
Todd Eldridge. Well, whether or not his ankle was bothering him, he nevertheless had trouble on this triple axel. Right there, he landed. He did not check the shoulders to stop the rotation and fell out of the jump. But you can see here the quality of his spins as he moves from backward to forward, from sitting position to backspin and arms over the head. First-rate spinner.
So out of breath, Todd, now with the first set of marks for skating techniques, 5.5s and one 5.7.
And these marks relatively lower than what he usually gets. We saw the problem he had on that one triple axel. But in the presentation marks, he also got relatively low marks, and that is because I don't think the program works quite as well as some of his other programs do. But remember, it's early in the season, and he has a long time yet to go to get into it and learn how to bend with it. Whatever it is, he's got a great sense of humor, and he really has fun in these competitions.
Trying to get the crowd to influence the judges, and I don't think that's going to work. I've never seen that work. And up next, Alexei Yagudin looks to make a clean start. The world champion takes the ice when we come back.
Back in Orlando, Florida, the home of Disney World and one of the country's most popular vacation spots. We, of course, are the home of all the best figure skating during this festive season. And what better to celebrate with than none other than the Brian Boitano Holiday Special. It gets underway Monday at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, right here on ESPN.
From Russia, for Alexei Yagudin.
So we begin to see if Alexei Yagudin, the two-time and reigning world champion, can begin to put his troubles behind him. Certainly did not have many troubles on the ice over the past 2 years. The 19-year-old from St. Petersburg, Russia, now living and training in Freehold, New Jersey.
The music is the soundtrack of Broken Arrow by Hans Zimmer. And it's a typical Russian story, one in the sense of which he has a friend who is killed, and he has to avenge his death. Very serious, very Sturm und Drang, very Russian, deep and dark.
By the way, the 94 Olympic champion, Alexei Ermanov of Russia, skated a short time ago. His marks good enough to keep Russia in the lead, 21-19.
Triple axel. That had wonderful height to it. Jump was intended to be a triple. It only was a double, as though he slipped off the edge. The fact that the skaters here are not allowed to do more than four triple jumps, that is his third in this program, means that there's extra time that they can use to create whatever their interpretation of the music is. Gives them a little more chance to breathe. Again, he fell off the toe pick and only completed a double. His technical marks, I feel, will be somewhat reduced by this second example of the loss of a triple jump. Final spin, a combination spin. Well, this certainly was a very serious program. I don't care how you look at it. It didn't have much flair or much excitement, or really the drama didn't come across to me very well, but it certainly was serious, no matter how you look at it.
Alexei Yagudin, the native of St. Petersburg, Russia, now living in the U.S., wants to be an American citizen as soon as possible, he says. And up next, one of the men looking to take away the world gold medal of Yagudin, Michael Weiss, the U.S. champ, takes the ice next.
Figure skating is not the only sport for which we are the home. ESPN is now the exclusive home for all NHL action. On Tuesday, starting at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, it's a National Hockey Night doubleheader on ESPN2. Watch Steve Yzerman and the Detroit Red Wings take on Miroslav Satan and the Buffalo Sabres. Then, at 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific, the resurgent Rangers take on a Phoenix Coyote attack led by Jeremy Roenick.
Terry Lotion, Figure Skating Classic continues. Alexei Yagudin with his coach, Tatiana Tarasova, and the first set of marks for skating techniques.
And the American judge clearly lower. Maybe she's influenced by the very serious nature of this program. I mean, the presentation marks, I think, also show that she was not quite as happy. This subject matter might be more suitable for Dostoevsky or Tolstoy rather than for a skating competition in Orlando, Florida.
It may not have been his best performance, but those marks the best we have seen so far here in Orlando.
puts a lot of pressure on the American team and the lone American man left to skate, Michael Weiss.
He is the reigning United States national champion and world bronze medalist, Michael Weiss.
Well, the first father to become the U.S. champion since, what, 1934. Roger Turner did it then. And Michael Weiss, about to become a papa once again. A couple of weeks from now, his wife Lisa will give birth to a baby son. Here is the reigning U.S. champion. There's his wife, Lisa, who made the trip unexpectedly. Michael didn't think she'd come down from Fairfax, Virginia, but she is here. Annie Mae, their daughter, is here as well.
You know, this was an interesting conception for him. I think the music and the style and the staccato quality, the abruptness of it, is rather well suited to him. He isn't the world's most graceful skater, and therefore when he does a program like this, I think it really fits him very well and is good for him.
Now, on this triple axel, watch the landing edge right there. You see how it changes edge and has a jerky movement. He can improve that. But these steps, very nice within the framework of this program.
What is ahead skating-wise for Michael Weiss this year? No one knows, but we do know his family continues to grow. There's Lisa, his wife, on the right of the screen. Susie Wynn has stepped in to join them.
Michael and Lisa, you're expecting another baby. How do you guys manage this great skating schedule with parenthood?
I don't know. I think parenthood has just brought us so much joy recently that, you know, happy people are happy athletes. And, you know, it's been working for me so far, you know. Family and my kids and my wife have meant everything to me. And everything going so great in my life right now just improves my skating that much more.
Now, what would it take and how would it feel to win a world title?
That would be the icing on the cake, definitely. I mean, the ultimate goal is a world title. And, you know, I got to start off well here in the beginning of the season with this event here. Went well for me, so I'll just continue that on for the world.
Well, continued success to both of you. Congratulations.
All right, Susie, thank you. Important scores here because if Michael Weiss can overtake Yagudin, it could put the U.S. into the lead. But another wide range, Dick, 5.4 to 5.7 for skating techniques.
Well, actually, you know, that's a relatively close range in the sense that they're not up in the 5.8s or 5.9s, and all the judges are within a point. This is a wider range between a 5.3 and a 5.7, and I think that depends upon their interpretation of on the waterfront. The program does need development.
In any case, the mark's not good enough to overtake Alexei Yagudin, so Russia with the lead, 24 to 19. So the U.S. ladies will try to mount a comeback. Sasha Cohen, 14 years of age, she'll be part of that comeback bid, as will 14-year-old Sarah Hughes. Two of the bright young stars. Michelle Kwan, now a college student, so new challenges ahead for Michelle, the two-time world champion. And from Russia, more confident than ever, Maria Butyrskaya, the reigning world champ. Skating's two superpowers continue to clash here in Orlando after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Welcome back, everyone, to Orlando Arena here in Central Florida. The Kerry Lotion Figure Skating Classic continues. And the ice dancing competition here in Orlando, here is a look at the current U.S. champions, Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev.
Now, they're skating to a program choreographed by Christopher Dean. You can see a lot of his moves and his style in this program. They need continued work on it to be able to really swing with it. But in the meantime, it has some lovely line. In some very beautiful positions.
And their competitors here in Orlando, Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov of Russia, the best in the world the past two seasons.
And this program to Carmen, sometimes over the top, but always entertaining. And what is going to be much more entertaining over the course of this year is the fact that they will be skating to Carmina Burana, the same music that their most serious competitors, Anissina and Pezerat of France, will be using in their free dance program. And if you don't think that'll cause a little bit of a ruckus in this world of ice dancing, I'll eat my hat.
So as the ladies are on the ice warming up, this competition still very much in doubt. Russia with a 30 to 24 lead over the U.S. off the efforts of Krylova and Ovsyannikov. But the ladies on the ice right now include Sarah Hughes, the 14-year-old who was the silver medalist from the Junior World Championships last year, then in her first trip to the Senior Worlds, placed seventh. Great first year for the 14-year-old from Great Neck, New York. Another teenager, this one from Russia, Yulia Soldatova, 18 years of age, from Moscow, the 98 Junior World Champion and then the bronze medalist at the Senior Worlds last year in Helsinki. And the 4'9", 14-year-old from Laguna Niguel, California, Sasha Cohen, the U.S. junior silver medalist in 99. She is going to be in the spotlight for some years to come. Her petite appearance is misleading. She is mature well beyond her years and has lofty goals entering the senior ranks.
At Nationals this year, I'm training really hard for it right now. And if all goes well and I skate really well there, I'm hoping to place in the top four. My strength comes from more of my artistic moves, the program, how I put it together, and some of my spins are my strength.
Sasha's strengths are similar to those of her training partner, U.S. silver medalist Naomi Nari Nam. A little healthy competition in practice has helped both skaters.
We look at each other and we'll maybe learn different things that the other one does better, and we'll work on it and we'll get better.
Here in Orlando, Sasha will have the opportunity to learn from the best and also make her television debut.
Well, I'm really excited about having the chance to skate with all of them. It's a great opportunity for me. And usually I see these people on TV, and I'm really excited that I'm going to be a part of them.
She began as a gymnast, but her mother, who happens to hail from Russia, by the way, thought the sport was too dangerous. So at the age of 7, she put on a pair of skates and took to the rink. Her practices this week have captured everyone's attention.
She has a wonderful presence on the ice, good posture, and a very straight back.
Sasha told me yesterday that she is not 100% for this competition. She has some inflammation in the growth plate of her right heel. She was on crutches a month ago and has only been on the ice practicing her jumps for the past 2 weeks. In fact, she has had to take a couple of her triple jumps out of this program.
Watch with this young lady is the way she stretches her legs, ending them in most beautifully pointed feet. And look at this double axel. Very neat, clean, and tight, fast revolution. First rate, triple salto. Extraordinary awareness of style and position on the ice.
And wonderful extension, and she really feels this music. Nice triple salchow.
She has one of the finer laybacks in the world of skating. Beautifully turned out leg, the hip, the relationship to the knee and the back of the foot. Extraordinary. And look at the extension on this spiral.
Triple coming up after this footwork is a triple toe loop. Right there. Very solid.
Beautiful positions. Really a young lady who is far ahead of herself in performance ability. Her style, her positions, her extension,
Sasha Cohen,
the
ladies and gentlemen,
feet,
Sasha Cohen.
They belie the fact that she is only 14 years of age.
She's stunning.
Looking for bright new stars? Look no further. 14-year-old Sasha Cohen.
And this is her exquisite layback spin. Look at the leg position and the arms, the arch in the back. Beautifully done. That is an excellent layback spin. And this is her Charlotte move, where she has like a perfect split in her leg. Very under control. That edge is very steady. Beautifully done.
Her nickname at her home rink in Costa Mesa, China Doll.
I love it. Cohen. I love it. 4.8s and a 4.7 for technical marks. Well, I mean, that's kind of ridiculous because the jumps are exquisitely done. So are the spins and so are the elements. And also these marks, I mean, in comparison, those marks are those low marks are given to her because she's 14 and a junior skater. No other reason.
The Magic Kingdom and Disney World, not far from here. We are inside Orlando Arena. The Carrie Lotion Figure Skating Classic continues. But a reminder, the ISU Grand Prix of Figure Skating concludes its tour on January 30th. The best stars of today take the ice alongside the brightest stars of tomorrow in the ISU Grand Prix Final, right here on ESPN.
And as the 18-year-old from Moscow, Yulia Soldatova, takes the ice, the Russians have the lead, 36-29, based on the scores given to Victoria Volchkova, which ranged from 4.9 to 5.5. She edged out Sasha Cohen of the U.S. But here is the world bronze medalist.
About a bronze medal in her first trip to the World Championships last season in Helsinki, and that coming off a junior world title in 98 for Yulia.
And she surprised us all. She has a lot of spark and flair to her skating. Nice triple Lutz. Maria Buterskaya, and that has to be helpful to her. It has to be inspiring to train next to the current world champion.
Finished right behind Maria at the Russian Nationals in second place the last two seasons. And at Europeans last year.
This program so far is very pleasant. Her skating is very pleasant. Everything is very nice. None of it is outstanding yet.
Well, I think the whole package doesn't really bring out her best qualities. I mean, she's finishing off these moves, and she's completing most of the triples and spins, but it's just not packaged to really present her at her best.
Well, I think the arms are sort of flinging all over the place, and there's lots of movement, but they don't come from the rest of her body. They don't build out of the music.
There's a lot of flailing of arms, a
list that is not very good. Camel sit spin combination, a layback that could take a lesson from Sasha Cohen, and a back Denise Bielman catch spin. Goodness.
But she's real pleasant to watch.
Yes,
she really is.
It was all very nice, and that's where it ended. Mm-hmm. If she is going to beat out Maria Butyrskaya, who has faults of her own, but is nevertheless has tension and dedication and speed and hard work, and Michelle Kwan, who has all, so many qualities, she's going to have to come a long way.
Little ways to go, but Yulia Sodanova completed the podium last season in Helsinki, capturing the bronze medal, her effort in the first competition of this new season.
And up next, 14-year-old Sarah Hughes. The American comeback must start with her. She's backstage preparing with her coach, Robin Wagner. The U.S. ladies must finish 1-2-3 for the Americans to have a chance to win here in Orlando. Look at the Dumbo ride over at Walt Disney World. Orlando, of course, one of the nation's top vacation spots and plenty to do for the entire family here. Yulia Sodanova, the world bronze medalist, awaiting her marks for skating technique, stick, 5.3s and 5.4s.
Well, those are very mediocre marks, and I must tell you, I think that the overall performance was mediocre as well.
And she is obviously not pleased, already up and walking off, got the boot off, hobbling away before her presentation marks even come up.
Would you please welcome now, from the United States, Sarah Hughes.
Only 14 years of age, from Great Neck, New York, Sarah Hughes takes the ice now, fourth at the U.S. Nationals last season, but how about the seventh place finish in Helsinki?
You know, something very interesting happened here. It was complete, it was steady, she built and she held everything through the program. I mean, it was nice to see such development and such maturity and such a sort of a complete way she went into this. It held together. She didn't flake off. I mean, it was just very nice. Now, that shows a skater that can perform under pressure.
The most famous freshman in the class at Great Neck North High School on Long Island, Sarah Hughes, 14 years of age, and her coach, Robin Wagner, to congratulate her.
And this was her triple lutz that actually was like a flutz. She made that edge flip over to an inside, which makes it a flip. So that has been a controversy this past year on her triple lutz. And this was her beautiful layback spin. Look at that turnout in her leg and her foot. Exquisitely done.
Sarah and her coach, Robin Wagner, who picks her up, drives an hour to practice every day. Remember, she has to beat Yulia Soldatova with these scores. 5.3 to 5.5 for skating techniques.
And they're very credible marks, and that's because the program, as represented by these marks, had a beginning and middle and an end. It was theatrical, it was complete, and it was just fine.
Soldatova wins the matchup, though, and Russia with the lead. The U.S. can only hope to tie now. Still, plenty of motivation for Michelle Kwan, twice the world champion, her title taken away last year by Maria Butyrskaya. They go head-to-head once again, and the Russian is supremely confident.
Today, both of us are the leaders in women's figure skating. It is interesting to watch Michelle. It is interesting to watch me. We both have new programs. It will be an interesting competition.
Maria has a lot of strengths in her skating. For one, she's a beautiful skater. She's a great jumper. She just has the all-around package, and that's what people are looking for.
Her strength is that she is American, and she is in America. I think I will not win this one because it is her country. Now let her come to Europe, and then we will see what happens.
The top two skaters in the world are still to skate when we continue after this message.
Representing Russia, a warm welcome, please, for Irina Slutskaya.
Here is Irina Slutskaya of Russia. Hard to believe she's 20 years of age. Remember when she was 16, burst on the scene with a European title, the first Russian woman ever to win that. She won it twice, in 96 and in 97.
My favorite memory of her is when I said, "May I pinch your cheeks?" And she said, "Oh, yes, all the old men like to do that."
Irina was pretty much written off as a skater last year because of her disappointing performances, but I think over the summer she's made dramatic improvement in her skating. Watch her speed, and her movements are much more with feeling, and she's feeling the music more and extending more than she ever has.
Angela Nikodinov of the U.S. has already skated and received marks ranging from 5.2 to 5.7. Remember, the U.S. can only hope to tie at this point.
Beautiful triple lutz, good spring to her jumps. That was her strength, were her jumps.
You noticed how that just rose up out of the steps. There was no enormous emphasis on it. It just fit into the music and flowed out of the program like this double axel did. Also, I might add that this costume is extremely effective for her. The long and flowing skirts hides the fact that sometimes her legs are not always positioned as well as they should be.
It's a very flattering look on her. It's all part of the overall package that a skater must present.
Beautiful, beautiful revolution on that tight, clean legs, my goodness.
Beautiful triple loop. The
this expressiveness to the music. This is all such a huge improvement for Irina. On both legs.
I think what both you and Peggy, if I can speak for both of us, is that we've liked her as a person. We've liked her energy and her jumping ability. We felt sorry that she didn't have style and presence and that her legs were sometimes not straight. But the fact is, I think this year she has matured into a young lady who has just been able to pull everything together and change her style completely. And that just is nice to see. And she has a nice smile on top of
it. The ever-present smile, and good reason for that right now, coming off a solid performance for Irina Slutskaya of Russia. We'll have her marks, and then it's the two-time world champion, Michelle Kwan, who will take the ice. She's already out there warming up. Her first performance of the new season when we return to the Kerry Lotion Figure Skating Classic. Back in Orlando, Florida, where the Millennium Celebration has already begun over at Walt Disney World. You don't have to wait until New Year's Eve here. From now until January 1st, 2001 at Epcot Center, we're showcasing the accomplishments of today and those that may shape our tomorrow. And back inside Orlando Arena. The scores now for Irina Slutskaya of Russia. Very good. 5.6, the rest 5.7.
Oh, they're really wonderful marks, and I think they reflect the fact that she has made such a turnaround in her performance and in her program.
And now for presentation. Oh, those are even higher. 5.7 to 5.9, and now the U.S. cannot even hope to tie. Irina Slutskaya has solidified the win for the Russian team. Your score right now, 47 to 36, so an 11-point margin with the Russians in front.
12 points. Three-time U.S. national champion, two-time world champion, Olympic silver medalist, Michelle Kwan.
So she may not be able to bring her team back to victory, but plenty of motivation, as we have said, for Michelle Kwan. Anytime that she and Maria Butyrskaya are on the ice in a competition together. 19 years of age, and one of the most celebrated incoming freshmen ever at UCLA now. Just arrived on campus the day before she came here to Orlando.
And she selected this piece of music because the song really touched her.
Controlled.
Well, this
has a real calm feeling to it. Very gentle, very soft.
Her triple jumps are neat, easy, very controlled, beautifully revolving jumps. And this layback position, the fourth of this program, was a wonderful position, much better than what she was doing last year.
She turned out her foot and arched that leg with a much prettier line.
Final scratch spin. You don't see many skaters attempting a forward scratch spin because of their difficulty.
She is so special.
It's a very complete program. I mean, and she performs it in a complete manner. I mean, it's just so well-rounded.
New challenges ahead for Michelle Kwan this season. She just arrived on the UCLA campus, started classes, staying in the dorm. She's going to have to juggle three classes in all the competitions this year, but she's always handled the challenges in her life, and a terrific way to begin here in Orlando. Michelle Kwan.
And this was her triple salchow. She did so smoothly. It just flowed from the very takeoff to the landing. Very nicely done, very confident. And this is a look at her improved layback spin. Watch the angle of her leg and her foot. It's all turned out. It's a much prettier position. And then she puts it down for another angle and a different look. Very nicely done.
Over the past 4 years, Michelle has won either gold or silver at every U.S. Nationals, Worlds, or Olympics. The first set of marks for skating techniques.
And those marks are so good because she really is the complete package. She spins beautifully with elegant positions. She jumps cleanly and completely. And she has wonderful edging going in and out.
And a perfect six, the rest 5.9s for presentation.
And I think that reflects the fact that this program is a charming, beautiful program that fits this kind of competition very well.
The 40th perfect six of Michelle Kwan's career. Easily the best marks that we have seen in the competition here in Orlando so far, but there is one skater left, the woman who took the gold medal away at Worlds a year ago. Maria Butyrskaya takes the ice next. The 1999 Kerry Lotion Skating Classic is brought to you by new Kerry Fast Absorbing Lotion. Strong enough to be Kerry, fast enough for you. It was a
testament to her dedication and perseverance, Maria Butyrskaya, of course, became the oldest ladies world champion in history in Helsinki last season. Now she's out to grab that title once again. Here she is, her first competition of this season. And we'll see how she reacts after the great performance of Michelle Kwan moments ago.
The music, Habanera from Carmen, performed by Rebecca Luker.
Well, Maria had the goal of being world champion in her mind since she was a little girl. And now that she's world champion, I can see a dramatic change in the command over the ice that she now has, that confidence.
Loop jump up, and she fell out of that one too. One thing that I think has improved here is that she's presenting a very sexy and very sort of complete acting kind of program, and I think this fits her nicely.
Well, in the practices, she was skating so well and exuding such maturity and confidence. Wonderful footwork section. Really interprets this music, keeps the speed up. Nice attitude.
The unevenness and the stiffness of her landings really shows up. One of the laybacks that you put on my list of great laybacks.
I knew we'd find one that Dick didn't like.
It was her foot, her free leg. But I did like
it. Like the end of that. Wasn't that nice? I mean, we're both alike. We really like, I think this program, you know, brought out some wonderfully good acting qualities and feminine, very sexy qualities that she has. Unfortunately, the failures in the triple jumps and the movements, other than that, spoiled and marred the entire program. It was not her night.
And Dick, you're right. We've seen her history. When she's off, she is really off. And when she's on, she's very, very good.
Maria Butyrskaya.
And this was the beginning of the disaster of this program, the triple lutz. She was leaning in the air. There was no way she could have saved that landing. It was a real unfortunate beginning. And then went right into the triple loop, where she had, again, some problems on that. The turning in the air was not even, and she couldn't pull out for that landing and check her hip.
Oh. Six times the Russian ladies champion. Maria Butyrskaya, the first set, 5.5 to 5.7.
And those marks were very generous within the context of this performance.
And for presentation, a wide range there, 5.5 up to 5.8 from the Russian judge.
I think also somewhat generous because the interpretation and the choreography was marred by the failure in the technical elements.
Certainly not the way that Maria Butyrskaya wanted to begin this new season. A disappointing performance for her, but not her team. The Russian team, of course, with all four of the world champions from last year, with the 48-38 win over the U.S. team. For Michelle Kwan, however, she began her new season in grand style. Terrific performance, and she is with Susie Wynn right now. Susie?
Thank you so much, Terry. Michelle, beautiful job out there. How did you switch gears from your first week at UCLA to skating a brilliant performance?
Well, I just started school 2 days ago, and it was hard to switch gears, actually. It was like I'm in UCLA walking at the beautiful campus, and then the next day I'm in Orlando. Go figure, you know? But I really like this program, and as long as I just skate from the heart and have fun, that's all that matters.
Now, your next competition is Skate America. Will you be setting in motion sort of trying to regain your world title?
I never think about regaining a title because it's not mine to begin with. So I'm just going to go out there and, you know, attack and, you know, go for all the jumps and see how it comes out.
We wish you all the best, and we look forward to watching your skating through all the Grand Prix series.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Red, white, and blue colors flying high here in Orlando, but the Russian flag, they finish on top. Been a great start to our figure skating season. For Peggy Fleming, Dick Button, and Susie Wynn, I'm Terry Gannon. Remember, ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com.